understand me when everything I do is wrong.
Good morning, and please stand and join us for our opening song. You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. If you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you
may the grace and the peace and the love of God, our Heavenly Father, be with each and every one of you. At the very beginning of Carol's life, she was welcomed into the family of God through baptism May this holy water remind us of that baptism that she received and the promise that was given to her that her Lord and God would walk with her each and every day of her life here on earth. Let us remember that the promise of baptism does not end at the time of death, but that in a very beautiful way, Carol is able to now be walking with our Lord and God in heaven. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, Jesus, who died on a cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all those who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant, Carol, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this in the name of your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one Lord and God, forever and ever. And at this time, I invite you to please be seated.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? To my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all like I can only imagine? I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? To my knees or will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all like I can only imagine? Yeah, I can only imagine. Forever worship you. I can only imagine.
As human beings, we can only imagine the great love that you have for each and every one of us, our Lord and God. As we are gathered here to thank you for the gift of life that you have given to Carol and how she was able to share that life with us, we now open our hearts and our minds and our souls to you as we listen to your word being spoken to us.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. At that time, there shall arise Michael, the great prince, guardian of your people. It shall be a time unsurpassed in distress, since nations began until that time. At that time, your people shall escape, everyone who is found written in the book. Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake. Some shall live forever. Others shall be an everlasting horror and disgrace. But the wise shall shine brightly, like the splendor of the firmament. And those who lead the many to justice shall be like the stars forever. The word of the Lord.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against the stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And hold you in the of his hand.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I saw a large white throne and the one who was sitting on it. The earth and the sky fled from his presence, and there was no place for them. I saw the dead, the great and the lowly, standing before the throne, and the scrolls were opened. Then another scroll was opened, the book of life. The dead were judged according to their deeds by what was written in the scrolls. The sea gave up its dead. Then death and Hades gave up their dead. All the dead were judged according to their deeds. Then death and Hades were thrown into the pool of fire. Anyone whose name was not found in the book of life was thrown into the pool of fire. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. The word of the Lord.
May the grace and the peace and the love of God, our Heavenly Father, be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to go and prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you may also be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to Jesus, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" And Jesus said to Thomas, and he says to us, "I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." My sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord. I do invite you to please be seated. And first of all, I do want to let you know that on behalf of myself and the parish community, we are in a very special way praying for Carol so that she may be able to be free from all pain, from all anxiety, and that she may be able to be enjoying the presence of being one with our Lord and God in heaven and with all those other people who have gone before her. Then we also want to let you know that we're praying for you as you go through this time in your life, that you may be able to know that as you share hugs, as you share tears, as you share memories, you're not alone. That our God wants to be just a little bit closer to you at this time in your life. When I had the opportunity to meet with a family the other day, one of the things that I heard from them very quickly and very loudly, that their mom was a mom of faith, a person of deep faith, of strong faith. And it is more than appropriate that they place on top of her the rosary and her prayer cards, because they often talked about how she was a person who continually prayed. And after listening to them talk a little bit, I know why, as a mom, she was praying for the three of you. In fact, she was so concerned about them that she gave each of them a guardian angel. A guardian angel is to a very special statue that is to remind you that you have this person up in heaven kind of watching over you. But only as moms can do, She didn't quite trust the guardian angels enough, because if they went away on a longer trip, they needed to call mom to make sure that they got safely to their destination. Even at the age of 50, got to call mom, which is a very wise thing to do. And I don't know how God works in our world. And I don't know how God calls people to be in heaven or why. But when I know the struggles that are a part of your family at this time, I cannot help but begin to think that in a very beautiful way, as God and Carol were able to be joined together with each other in heaven, that Carol said something like this: God, I know my family needs another guardian angel to watch over them as they go through the not only my death, but all of the other struggles that are a part of their life at this time. So don't be surprised if all of a sudden you get a gentle tap on your shoulder and it feels just like mom is there. And then as we listen to the readings, our readings talk very clearly about the fact that while we are alive here on earth, we have the ability to have bodies that we do and to see and to feel the things that we can do. But our readings also tell us that there's more at the end of our life. There's a new heaven and a new earth. And that somehow people are like shining stars in the heavens. And as we listen to the Gospel of John, we first of all hear about the beautiful relationship that Jesus and his Father have. And all too often, I think, in our lives as human beings, and when we think about faith, we forget that it's based off of relationships. The relationships that we have with one another. The relationship that Carol had with all of you. And I don't think that relationship stops at the time of death, but that it continues on in a different way. And then we hear Jesus making a promise, not only to the disciples, but to each and every one of us. In my Father's house, there are many rooms, and I'm going to prepare a special place for you. I don't know exactly what that special place looks like for Carol, but I wouldn't be surprised if there's a couple 5-cent slot machines in one of those rooms. And she's getting those slot machines ready for some of her friends. I also wouldn't be surprised if there's some sort of a kitchen area where she can prepare lots of food, lots of snacks, lots of treats, not only for you guys, but she's probably already giving some away. And then I wouldn't be surprised if someplace in this special room, there isn't kind of a voice-activated or motion-activated voice detector that somehow sounds like each one of her three boys at a different time saying something like this: Mom, the ice cream is out. We pause to thank God for the life that Carol was able to share with all of us. We know that there's sadness as we say our goodbyes, as we begin to try to understand what it means to live without her. being physically present to us. But I also believe it's very important for us to truly remember, as I started off, she was a person of deep faith. And I can't help but believe that in her own way, she, along with God, has called each of you to be here today, not only to pray for her, but to pray for each other. But most importantly, to allow yourselves to be opened up to receive the Eucharist, to allow for God's great love to enter into our humble lives as human beings. And at this time, I invite for our leaders of prayer to come forward, and for the rest of us to please stand for the prayers of the faithful. We do turn to you as our loving God and offer now these prayers for Carol and ourselves. And I invite you to respond to each of these petitions by praying, Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who trusted in the Lord, now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Carol, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, may she now be admitted to the company of the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, may they have the reward of their goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, may we be gathered together again in God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Do, Lord and God, hear these prayers, hear the prayers we hold deep in our hearts, and give us the ability to be one with your Son, now and forever. And at this time, I do invite you to please be seated and to just think about the ways in which you can allow your heart and your souls to be open to the love of God.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved and set me free. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first believed. Through God has promised good to me, his word my hope secures. He will my portion be, as long as life endures.
pray, my sisters and brothers, so that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Heavenly Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Carol, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a loving and merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of the blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of the immortality that is to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and the archangels, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
And at this time, I invite you to feel free to either kneel or be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Carol, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember all of our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and of all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Carol, and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, that we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Alleluia. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in all of our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "My peace I give to you, my peace I leave with you." Look not now upon our sin, but rather upon the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace and the love of our Lord Jesus be with you always. I invite you to take a moment to share with one another the sign of God's love and peace.
You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. For the reception of the Eucharist this morning, we'll invite you to come down the center aisle and then to feel free to either kneel or be seated as you return back to your place.
And let all the poor
let them come to the water. Bring the ones who are laden, bring them all to the Lord. Bring the children without might. Easy the load and light. Come to the Lord.
O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, we thank you for hearing our prayers on behalf of your servant Carol, whom you have called out of this world. And because she has put her hope and trust in you, command that she be carried safely home to heaven and come to enjoy your eternal reward. We ask this in the name of your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one Lord and God, forever and ever. Amen. And at this time, the family has asked me to let you know that they truly appreciate your love and support at this very important time in their lives and in Carol's life. And as a token of appreciation, they invite you to a luncheon that will take place over at Hollander's immediately after our prayer is finished. And for those of you who may not know where that is, go up to Main Street, take a right, and about a mile down the road on your left-hand side is Hollander's. Please continue to support the family and to share memories of Carol. I invite you to please stand. Before we do go our separate ways, it is now necessary for us to take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness. May it strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet Carol again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. And at this time, I invite for each of you to offer a silent prayer for Carol.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near.
when my life is almost gone. Hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the night draws near, and the day is past and gone, at the river I'll stand. Guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we do commend our sister Carol, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will be one with you on the last day. We do give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Carol in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with all of the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, do turn toward us. Hear our prayer. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace, let us now take our sister to her place of rest. Carol, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the holy martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
Just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to thee, let it be, dear Lord, let it be. I am weak, but thou art strong. Jesus, keep me from all wrong. I'll be satisfied as long as I walk. Let me walk close to thee. Just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to thee, let it be, dear Lord, let it be.